And good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Out front tonight, the breaking news. A White House official telling CNN tonight that the West Wing has still not seen the Mueller report. But President Trump does not need the full report to declare victory.
I love this country as much as I can love anything. My family, my country, my God. But what they did, it was a false narrative. It was a terrible thing. We can never let this happen to another president again. I can tell you that.
And with that, all the talk of witch hunts and hoaxes and witch hunts and hoaxes and witch hunts and hoaxes is over. Now, that is certainly a change of heart, because clearly the president expected something else from Mueller. In fact, his lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, bluntly said that Attorney General Barr's memo was, quote, better than I expected. Barr, of course, says Mueller found no collusion with Russia. And while Mueller didn't reach a conclusion on obstruction of justice, Barr has cleared the president on the issue of obstruction. But without the full report, of course, there are still many questions tonight. For instance, why President Trump and so many people in his orbit lied about their contacts with Russia? Why was former campaign chairman Paul Manafort allegedly sharing polling data with a Russian with ties to Putin's intelligence agencies? Why did the Trump campaign gut the GOP's anti-Russian stance on Ukraine? What are President Trump's financial ties to Moscow, and how important was that tower in Russia? The full Mueller report may answer some, but not all, of these questions. President Trump, though, is, of course, changing his tune, hiding behind his attorney general, but saying today he is fine with the full report being released to the public.
Up to the attorney general, but it wouldn't bother me at all.
It wouldn't bother him at all, and it would at the least explain the many actions of Robert Mueller. Don't forget, he criminally charged 37 people and entities, 29 of them Russian, 6 of them Trump associates, 199 criminal counts. This is unprecedented. Paul Manafort alone will spend the next 7.5 years in prison. He was the chairman of a presidential campaign. This will go down in history, which is why there is more we need to know. And releasing the report will be a big step to understanding how Mueller came to his conclusions. But whether we see Mueller's full report or not, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee says there are still other crucial questions.
Our investigation has always focused on counterintelligence issues. That is the president or anyone around him compromised in some way? That work has to go on.
That's a crucial question to imagine that we don't know the answer to. Shimon Prokipes is out front live in Washington. Shimon, obviously we have this 4-page summary, right? And then you have this report that we all hope we will get to see. But what the Chairman Schiff there is saying is the question of whether the president or anyone around him was compromised by Russia is a question that was not, that we still are working on. Was that even part of Mueller's investigation, answering that question?
Yeah, of course it was, and it continues to be something that the FBI and the counterintelligence will always, or I think counterintelligence investigators will always look for. But I think it's very clear from what we saw in the Bill Barr report is that they found no evidence that the Russians and people with Trump and the Trump campaign colluded with the Russians. The idea that there may be some kind of, let's say, someone may be compromised or the Russians may have somehow been able to breach the Trump campaign is certainly something that everyone wants to know more about, because you had so many people when they were asked questions about their involvement with Russians, so many people on the campaign, they had lied about it. So that had always investigators suspicious of that activity. So that is an ongoing process in terms of what were the Russians up to, certainly. But, you know, it's very clear from the report that we've seen so far, parts of that we've seen so far, that really, you know, the FBI did not find that there was anything criminal that was going on. Now, counterintelligence is very, very different, as you know, Erin.
Yeah, it is, obviously. And what kinds of conclusions you could reach from a counterintelligence perspective may or may not reach a criminal standard.
That's exactly right.
You know, when you're talking about things like assets and you know, foreign governments. When do you think, Shimon, that we might get the final report?
Right. So the members of Congress are saying they want it by April 2nd. That's probably a little too soon. It's not going to happen. I think what we saw from the Department of Justice this weekend, they were trying to move quickly, and they did. And I think that should keep everyone optimistic. We know they're going to continue to work on this report. Here, there's report, what people should understand is kind of in two parts, right? You have the obstruction part, and then you have the Russia collusion part. The Russia collusion part is going to be a little more difficult because that's where you're going to have all the classified and perhaps the grand jury information.
Right.
On the obstruction stuff, it's going to be more about interviews and the work that the FBI was conducting. Maybe we'll see a lot of what the president was tweeting in that part of their report. So that could be easier, and that could be something that the Department of Justice could do quicker. So we could see it come in part. So we could see the obstruction part first, and then at some point we would see the Russia collusion. But obviously I think what everyone really wants to see is the obstruction part of the report. And we may get that sometime in April, could be sooner.
And of course, you know, then we find today McConnell basically blocking, you know, the vote from Congress to release the whole thing. The president says he's for it. Is that real? Is he really for it at this point? Obviously, he would say, I've been exonerated. Why not
right.
put it all out there? But is that really what he wants?
I mean, it's hard to say, right? Because the president also said, yeah, sure, I'm willing to sit down with Robert Mueller and his team. And he never did, right? The president's lawyers protected him from that. He usually always says, okay, I want to do this. But then, you know, we hear weeks later, days later, he doesn't do it. So I think he's feeling good about it, as he should. And so that's why he's saying, yeah, let's put it out. But I don't think they know exactly everything that's in there right now.
All right. Thank you very much, Shimon. I appreciate it.